Okay, Jim Smith at Catapult Research. Today we're looking at the Dow Jones Utility Average, DJU. From this low, we draw a Gann fan. You can see we're testing it now. We actually got slightly above it, but it looks like we're forming a lower high at the line. This is important, and let me show you why. The next chart, this chart here, shows you a 48-month cycle, low to high, 132 months, low to high, 204 months, low to high. The anniversaries of prior lows and highs are important into the future. They can set up a change in trend. That's all we're saying. And do they work all the time? No, sometimes they don't work. But if you want to give yourself a better hedge, you can wait for a close below 820, which is the 1x1 zero line. A zero line is just a line drawn up from zero at the time of an important low or high. In this case, we're using a low. The time of the low, we're drawing the zero line up. Notice it catches this support here. Guess what? When it takes out 820, you're going to have a big move down in all probability. Nothing's guaranteed to work, but this looks pretty good to me. So keep an eye on the utilities. If you take out 820, be ready for a big slide. Now, if you want to make it more obvious, you can say, let's also look at this high to this high is 90 months, and then to this low, 90 months, 45 months. So there's something going on here. What exactly are we looking at? Well, we're looking at a good 45-month cycle. Low, high, low, high. This one, not so much. It looks like it didn't work. Low, high. Every 45 months, or almost every 45 months, you get a change in trend. And given the huge rally into this cycle, the odds are very good that you're going to turn down. So again, 820, once you take that out, you're probably going down. So one other way to look at it, a lot of people have the view that there's safety in the utilities, but I wonder if that's really true. Notice back here in August 2000, pretty much around the same time, with a variance of a couple of months, they both peaked at the same time. Same thing in 2007. Pretty much the same time. So you can't argue that it's happening now. Oh, but what I would say, to flip it on its head, let's say you take out 820 on the utilities and you start drifting down on the S&P. If that happens, you have something to worry about. It may, what I'm saying is the utilities might be a lead indicator for the S&P. If you see this support line give way, it may mean that the S&P is about to follow suit. So keep an eye on the utilities and the S&P to see if they're both, I mean, it's possible they will just keep going higher, but I doubt it. I think that even if the stock market goes higher, even if the S&P goes higher, there's a good chance the utilities won't, because imagine this. Most people were into this market for safety. Now, if the S&P starts to rally strongly, they don't need that safety. They'll switch to other sectors. So it makes sense they would dump this regardless. So if stocks go down, utilities are probably going to go down. If stocks keep going higher, utilities are probably going to go down. Heads I win, tails I win. I'm just saying, the odds are pretty stacked against this sector. I think it's had a big run-up. It's overdue for a pullback. But I wouldn't be betting the ranch on this. Do your own homework. There's fundamentals that I like that also support this case. California's having wildfires, and you wonder if people are going to disconnect from the grid, you know, because there's no benefit in a wildfire to be connected to the grid and lose your power and then lose your home. If you're off grid, maybe you can get by. Also, Barron's is quoting UBS saying solar and wind could make up 47% of the world's capacity by 2030, a more than doubling of the current level. So I'm saying that's interesting. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory says that 78% of our demand for electricity can be eliminated through energy conservation and energy efficiency improvements. And you probably already know California is moving to zero energy homes next year, which means they, in theory, don't need the grid. And I think that's the wave of the future. So if that really happens, why do we need a utility industry? You know, it's not going to happen overnight, but in some odd years down the road, the risk is the utilities disappear, or at least in some parts of the country, California being a good candidate. But let's see what happens. I think you got to do your own homework. You know, there is no risk-free trade out there. Don't look at this and say, hey, I should be selling utilities. I still think you need to do your own homework and, you know, get advice from other people. But I think the advantage of Gann is it can tell you something before the fundamentals are that obvious. And I think if you do take out 820, from a Gann perspective, this sector is in real trouble.